And hello. Now, this is the Cyber Magician back again, and here I am with Charles. And Charles is going to be doing a bit of stomping around the marketplace. So what we're going to do today, after we get our mail, which I just noticed, is that we're going to take a look at the subterrane. And we're actually going to go down there and kill off one of the guy's down there. It's going to be a rare. And we're going to get rid of him. So we're going to go in and take him out quite easily, I think. There's a key to it. And some people know this and some people don't. So we're going to show you how to do it. So here we are. Subterrane Central Level 18. Yes, Charles is a little overpowered for this, but this is just for favor, so it is what it is. So here he is. First thing you want to make sure is that you have Featherfall on. And he's going to cast all of his protection spells just to make sure that nothing goes wrong. And that should do it for now. All right, let's go pick a fight. So this is the reason why. It's a bit far down. And then we're going to go down to the right. Now, to see these emblems that are here? They have a tendency to show you a little bit of a secret. We're going to follow that. So this is one of the rare quests that you go, and we're going to look at how to get down there, and that's the whole purpose today. So there it is. There's our symbol again. And Gargamel is, you follow this G. So whatever side that you see this come up on, the G is on, that's the side you go to. And that will lead you directly to his location. Mind you, you're going to have to kill some things on the way. Which is fine, because they are A, killable, and B, slayers. So they'll add up, which is good, because it'll give you some XP. These lights here have a tendency to debuff you, so you want to stay out of the way of them. Oh, this is an old one. Must be a Sork. Yeah. And he's a destroyed one. Not dead, because he is dead already, but and down. So off we go. Now you notice up here it goes to the left, that G. So we're going to go down, we're going to go left. Oh, is he praying? Maybe. He ain't doing it no more, though. Such a nasty wizard. So, going to run around here. Don't hide. Come back. Thought I heard somebody else come there. So the G, again, is on the left-hand side. So we're going to do that after we take care of these pair of schmucks. Yes, you're a schmuck, so die. Thank you. What are you coming down here for? You're going to pick a fight with me too? Hunter. And he's hunting wizards, I guess. And here we go. Now, the nice thing about this whole thing is that I get to collect all the guys. So my count here is 168 or so far. Thank you very much. Nobody else sneaking up on me. There's a shrine back there, but no, I definitely don't need a shrine. Let's heat this guy up. And he's down. Beholder, you take him out from a distance because he will definitely debuff you. Now you notice up here in this circle, there's no G. So straight through. Come out, wherever you are. There you are. Hello, dudes. Yes, there, down they go. Oh, I am using my sentient weapon, so it has a tendency to talk to me. Which is fine. And nothing there, keep going straight. And they're dead. Nice and easy. Nobody here. Oh my God, where is he today? Fool around. Look, dudes. I'm trying to find Gargamel. Do you know the way? If you don't, stay out of my way. Thank you very much. Well, at least they add up to it. You cannot evade in armor. Yes, I know I can't evade in armor. Thank you very much. Now, why do I get a sneaky suspicion I'm in the wrong spot? Oh, good grief. Where the heck did I go wrong? Yes, I'm really good at it. There we go, come on. There we are, now I got the death aura up there, it's gonna help heal me. I'm gonna try and figure out where did I go wrong. Let's backtrack a little bit here. If you're not familiar with the quest, you can do this once in a while. Basically, pull a boo-boo. I'm not going to want to fight you. Go away. Now you reset. And you just backtrack to where you come from, and eventually what will happen is that you'll come up and go, okay, so that's where the G is. And that's the root. Yeah, there it is. Look at that. What'd I tell you? So I seen the G there. And it's on this side here, so we're going to go this way. Thank you very much. That's good. Now we're working the right way. So behind this door here is what I was after. This is the area that you'll have that actual rare quest going in. And you need Featherfall to go down and do it. But it's fairly easy to do. You just have to be able to get down to it in one piece. Which is why you gotta kill all these guys off. And when you do, then you can go into the quest itself. But they're being stubborn. Now, the worst thing with Charles is that he really doesn't have the strength of a fighter, so he doesn't do quite as much damage as a fighter does when he's beating on these guys. But that's fine. So we got it cleared. He's got his spell points back. He's going to open the portal. Ta-da! And he's going to redo his protection spells. once he has them, he's going to jump in. So as he floats down, you'll notice these emblems on there and circles. And you want to avoid them because they trigger the traps. And there's not much you can do except float down and try and avoid them as much as possible. You can't turn them off or anything like that, so that's a bit of a pain. See, there's an acid trap. And what you want to do is you want to float down in this one side over here. And what will happen then is that as you float down, he spawns. There he is. But remember, every once in a while, you get thrown back up through one of these levitation spells. But if you get in this corner and you wait for him to come over to see you, hi, buddy. How you doing? You're ready to die? See, look, he already threw. Come on. I already got thrown up. I don't want to touch the gold because it's going to, crap. Spawn all those guys. What a pain. Yes, die, you son of a fox feather. Oh, it threw me up just as I was going to use that spell. You turkey. Get back over here. Well, it's not working out very good for me today. I'll tell you that. Normally, by now, this guy's toast. But that's okay. I got a question for you. Who else is called Gargamel in an animation about very short blue creatures? Yes, Gargamel is the wizard for the anime. Or, pardon me, cartoon. Once we defeated him, we don't get levitated up anymore, and we can do what we want. So we got the two chests here. Oh, a ghostie. A ghostie with the mostie. And he's going to go down pretty cool. There he is. So now we can come down, and we can search through all this gold and see how much loot we can get. And after we kill off a few more skellies, of course. Come on. You take a long time dragging your butt up, dude. Make it easier on me. Shush. So anywhere you run around and you can see that icon change to the two wheels or gears, then you know it's a place you can search. And you can get some gold. You can get gold, you can get treasure, there's gems, platinum pieces. Prefer platinum, really. It's all I used to carry. Worth 10 gold. And we still have those other two chests up there to go through, too. Would you please, please recrease me, change my Earl. Yeah, you're a pain. Go growl someplace else. One of the things that Standing Stones now in DDO should do is that when you search through these piles of gold, from your perspective, they should disappear. Because that's what you've found. You've searched the pile and come up with those treasures. So this is an easy way, if they had implemented it, to indicate to you what you have searched through and what you have not. So it's real. It's a big deal because I'm still looking at all this gold laying around as far as I'm concerned. And it's like, I want to go back and search some more because there's more gold. But it's not. So you do a quick look around to make sure you get all the piles. And I missed that one. See? And once you do, then you're able to carry on and now get the treasure from the... Oops! Oh, I seen that. Ha ha ha. Tried to fool me. So you gotta come back and you gotta search a second time just to make sure you get everything. Because if you don't, you could miss a couple of thousand gold. And it adds up. So I'll come back up here. And now if I wanted to, I could do what is called a pike. Because the chests are not open yet, if I open this quest up to other people, they can join in right now, run down to where I'm at, and get the chests too. But I don't have enough time to wait for that stuff to go on. So I'm going to go through the chests myself and see what I get. I get a luck blade. What is a luck blade? Let's see. Luck blade is a short sword. It has three augment slots, orange, purple, and red. It is good luck plus one to saves and skill checks. And it's a plus two weapon and it's level 8. You're kidding me. It's a cotton picking level 8 weapon? Really? And you look in here, this area. If I recall out of here, what level is the central? Level 21. So why did I end up with a level 8 weapon in a level 21 explorer area? Don't know. Don't know. That's just the way things go in DDO. Yahoo. So I'm back here. I'm going to sell my junk, but I'm going to show you how that luck blade is going to come in a little handy. So there is my sentient weapon stats. I have two filigrees added. I have got 2595 sentient XP burnt into it. I need 6,000 for that last filigree. When I get the three pieces in, it's now going to do 10, 14 dice 6 of poison damage every time I hit somebody with it. Cool. So where is that luck weapon? Come out. There it is. So this is a level 8 luck weapon. So I got 2595. I got 8 points because at level 21, you get one experience point for every level. Really? Yippee-ki-yay. All right, let's sell the rest of this junk off. Anyways, that is the central location in the subterranean. Just adding up some explorer areas and adding some explorer points. And I hope you had a very pleasant little short time seeing where to go and how to follow it down. And like I say, if you make a mistake like I did, you can backtrack until you see that Emlyn showing you the G, which way to go. This is the Cyber Magician. Have yourself a pleasant day. Peace out.